Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I want to tell you that in this dark age, this is the age of Christ, you cannot blame a third person for any harm done to you, because you are supposed to seek the light. But if you follow the blind guides, then you become a blind and you fall into the pits of Holocaust and these cruel killing as is taking place in Iraq now. Remember that the second anointed Christ, Nanak, he visited Iraq to give them the light. But the greedy person from India, who became the custodian, they created darkness. They loved money more than God. Same in India. What gold has to do with golden temple? Nothing. So people who follow are the other people. They are blind. In the Bible, you see them that people say, I follow Jesus. You follow Jesus mean that you are a blind person. I don't follow him. I have ears to listen to his voice. And when I listen to his voice, then I go for it. I don't follow him, I go for it. I am a seeker. I seek wherever I can get the spiritual knowledge. I hear it with my ears and take it to my heart and preach it from my own mouth as expected of a Christ. I preach Christianity, but I'm not a Christian. Christians are people of the book, spiritually blind people. So that's why in Iraq, those spiritually blind people, Christians, they are getting killed. Because they have become Christian outwardly of the physical body. I am a Christ inside me. Outside I am of Jat tribe. My tribe is Jat. That's why in the Revelation, all those who will be saved are 144,000. They are all mentioned by their tribes, not as Jews or anything. So these spiritual self people who have become Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew, outwardly, they will fight and kill each other. The tear, they are the tear, they will burn and kill each other. Here I have written something, what happened, you know, to these things. Because Jesus was the first light, he came among the people who were spiritually Sikh people of Judah tribe. So, they were princes of darkness. And Judah Iscariot killed himself with just the rebuke Jesus gave him was a strong one enough to kill himself. But in India, we are princes, kings and emperors of darkness. So there the rebuke did not work. You have to use sword power. So four prophets came in the world. Two in the Middle East, they were John the Baptist, ideal rabbi, and Christ Jesus. Two in the East, Christ Nanak, we call him Satguru, and Royal King, Gobind Singh Ji. There were only four prophets in the world, no more than that. People can call others prophet. But you have to know the prophet yourself, not what the other people say. So if I am calling these four, you have to search yourself and come to your own conclusion. Don't follow anyone. If you follow somebody, then you are a spiritually blind person and you are not the master of your own destiny. Remember, the born blind person of John 9 gave you an ideal seeker of his word. That is the person we need to fish into the royal kingdom of God. Not those who are stooges of the Pope or of the bishops and other things. They are women. We can't fish them. So here is the story about how the things went wrong. Soon after the destruction of the temple in 70 AD, the wine press, the last parable Jesus gave in the temple, the temple rabbis became useless, good for no other job than the priestly. So they decided to catch their old customers in the church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, by jumping over the walls, you know, the fold. There were the sheep in the fold, and the thief jumps over the wall while the man who is of the owner or the son of the God, he passes through the proper gate where Christ Peter is there. Any liar or hypocrite is killed on the spot. But they jumped over the wall like a thief. With the forbidden Jewish leaven, the rotten written Torah, the old cloth full of holes or corruptions, and they poisoned the church of God by making the people drunk with the old wine of the letters as they were in Jerusalem. That Samaritan woman was not drunk with the old wine of the letters. So she wetted Jesus in spirit and found him to be a prophet. So when they were drunk with the old wine of the letters in the churches, they desired not the new wine, gospel, which is brewed by an individual on the individual basis through intuition. If you are capable of intuition or logical reasoning, then you will get the gospel. Apostles visiting such churches, dead in spirit, rebuked them, rebuked the bishop, you know, but the bishops installed in the fashion of the old destroyed temple, Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, made the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. Popes became cruel masters, and Christianity was doomed, leading to the appearance of the Gentile Hazrat Muhammad Sahib. You know, the Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, because they were killing the apostles, which were mostly Gentile, like flies. So they had to be stopped. And his Islam of mullahs, Inshmullahs, equally strong and cruel. So when they went to India, you know, they created havoc over there. That led to the appearance of second Jesus in the name of Nanak, Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. Satguru is the same thing as Christ. In the Punjab in 1469, and he preached Christianity or Sikhism to perfection. In Sikhism, the light was passed on to five more people, and they preached gospel for almost 150 years. Jesus preached only 4 years. Over there, it was preached 150 years, but still the cruel Mohammedans could not be overpowered, leading to the last fourth prophet, Royal King Gobind Singh Ji, who established the last two communities of Khalsas, the philanthropic soldiers of God that used sword power to subdue the stubborn sons of Satan. Now, Judas Iscariot did not need sword power. He just rebuke was enough, because he was the prince of darkness. Here in India, there were kings and emperors of darkness, so sword power was needed. And then the fourth community of apostles, who used the double-edged sword of his word to keep the light shining. But the most powerful sons of Satan, the kings and emperors of darkness, could not be subdued until the crook Mughals were overthrown by the relatively better-hearted Europeans, the English, you know, and Portuguese. They went there. And people again enjoyed the peace of mind. Today, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, the parable of wheat and tares is being fulfilled. These Jewish people, Jew outwardly, they are the tares. They are getting burned up in Israel for final burning. I can explain the parables in spirit. All these parables I can explain in spirit. And I have written two books, one in English, which I have given the ISBN number, and you can find it on Google, you know. And the other is in my native language, Punjabi. Both are on the Google. One God, one faith. Let him hear who has ears to hear. These ears are very rare people have. Those people who have common sense, they have the ears and they can hear it. Our Father God blesses you.